Dr. Vicki Peterson here. I want to review something that comes up often with patients, and that is when they say, I know vegetables are good for me, I know beans are good for me, but I can't eat them. Sometimes people note that they can't eat raw vegetables or salads without getting a stomach ache, or they can't eat cruciferous vegetables like broccoli and Brussels sprouts and cauliflower without being really gassy and really uncomfortable. And the same for beans with a lot of people. It's like, oh, I know they're good for me, but I just can't eat them. I'm so uncomfortable with gas and bloating, etc. It feels like I swallowed a brick. You know, a lot of different complaints potentially associated with that. And so they've sort of taken those foods and put them in the category of I can't eat them. So what I want to talk to you about today is that that is temporary until you get your gut handled. So it's not that broccoli is bad, it's that broccoli in a good way actually is hard to digest. Same with beans. And when your gut, when your digestive tract is not functioning optimally, it can seem like a negative. So it's not that the food is a negative, the beans aren't a negative, the raw vegetables aren't a negative. What is a negative is the health of your gut. So when patients come in and say, I can't eat certain foods like that, and they're super, super healthy foods, really what we want to do is use that as a guide to the fact that we need to restore health to their gut. You know, are you not making enough enzymes? Is there a lot of inflammation? Do you have food sensitivities? Are there bad bacteria or parasites in your gut? There's a lot of different things that can offset the good balance of the gut and make it difficult to digest things that are very, very good for you. And so that's what we want to get to the root of, not just say, wow, you know, if I do white bread and sugar, that's pretty easy to digest, so I'm going to eat a lot of that, and I'm going to stay away from the beans and the salad and the cruciferous vegetables. I'm just using those three as an example. That's not what you want to do. You want to get to that point where those are effortless for you. Now, when it comes to beans, which are very good for you, I know you've heard about lectins, and lectins are a real thing, but it's in the raw bean. So lectins are something that plants make to defend themselves against bugs, you know, things eating them. And so, but it's in their raw state. It's while they're growing, and it's their defense mechanism of don't eat me because you're going to get a stomach ache. And it works very well. But once a bean is cooked, there are no lectins anymore. So it's, you don't want to eat a raw bean for sure. You'll definitely get a bellyache. You can get quite sick, actually. But nobody's going to do that. It's next to impossible to chew a raw bean. So once they're cooked, and of course canned beans these days, you know, you can get organic beans and they're already cooked for you. There's no lectin issue with those. Now, with that said, you can eat beans, lectins aside, because of course they're fully and properly cooked, and you can eat them and get a lot of gas. So two reasons for that. One, you're just not used to consuming beans, and so you want to start with little amounts and slowly build them up, and you'll make increasing amounts of enzymes, and you'll find you tolerate beans very well. So we see that with patients all the time. Or it could be, as I was mentioning earlier, your digestive tract is just not functioning optimally, and something that's hard to digest, again, in a good way. So hard and good, you know, those sound like they shouldn't go in the same sentence, but realize these complex carbohydrates, certain vegetables, beans, they're tough to digest so that they get down into the lower part of your colon and feed your good bacteria, which is what you want. So these are very, very healthful foods, but if you're not tolerating them, that's a real situation, but it's not a permanent situation. So it's a good little guide, actually, that, wow, I eat broccoli and forget about it, I'm so uncomfortable. Okay, fine. That means we have some work to do, right? And you get that work done, and all of a sudden, oh, broccoli's your friend. And that cruciferous family of vegetables are anti-cancer. They're very, very important for ideal health that you're consuming a good 6 servings of vegetables a day and making sure you get at least a couple from that cruciferous vegetable family is very, very important. And if you're not tolerating it, again, it's not, okay, that's not my friend. No, it's gonna become your friend as soon as we get your gut functioning the way it should. Same with beans. So I hope I explained that well, and it's something you definitely want to aspire to, is to have these foods not only be your friend nutritionally, but be your friend as far as you feel good when you eat them. And optimizing that gut health is what we need to do to achieve that goal. So if you are in that sort of situation where you know things are good foods, but you don't seem to tolerate them well, it's not you, it's just the gut. And so we need to help normalize it, and then you'll get back to it and you'll get to enjoy these really good foods that are so important for optimal health. So if you need help assisting your digestive tract to function more normally, that's what we're here for. We don't use drugs, very rarely. It's a natural approach and very personalized to you to see what your digestive tract needs to become optimized. So reach out to me. I'm happy to do a consultation with you over the phone or, of course, in person. Give us a call, 408-733-0400, or you can visit the website, rootcausemedicalclinics.com. I'll see you soon.